you.
What does a lady got to do to get some Cheeto chicken fries around these parts?
We don't have those until Wednesday.
We don't have those until Wednesday. We don't have those until Wednesday. We don't have those until Wednesday.
Hey.
Whoa. What up?
What do you got?
I got the Cheeto chicken fries. He said they didn't have them.
Yeah, he said he didn't have them. How did you get them?
I got inside knowledge.
What do you mean?
Ta ta da da.
That's not them.
That's not.
Cheeto chicken fries. Made it home.
Oh my god, what's that white stuff?
So Burger King is at it again. Doing things. Again. And again. Except making a good burger.
So we couldn't get Cheeto chicken fries because they didn't come out yet. But I'm going to show you a hack on how you can make your own Cheeto chicken fries. Flamin'! Woo! Woo! Pop these open. Right in. Oh no, I didn't put the blade in. Damn it. If you want a finer texture, go with the puffs.
Are those Flaming Hot Puffs?
Yeah.
I didn't know that we had those.
Oh, you don't? You probably didn't know we had these either.
Oh, that looks good.
I go to gas stations, I see Flaming Hot, I get flaming excited, and then I buy them. All right, guys, so this hack is quite simple. You got your Cheetos, and you got your chicken fries. Into the fryer. Yes. I put the timer on for 2 minutes. It might be a little bit too long, because you don't want to overcook them and have them look burnt. The minute we take these out, they're going right into the Cheeto bowl.
I can do other things. I know I'm good. Please.
And then toss them right in.
Is it a fail hack, JP? I thought you had a great idea, but it didn't work.
Good. It just tastes like a chicken fryer.
Oh, what a shame.
All right, so how do we make your version?
So actually, this is going to be a little bit different than all of the other chicken fry recipes we've done before.
So instead of ground chicken like previous videos, we're going to be using chicken breasts. Square off the top and bottom of your chicken, and then make quarter inch slices like so. Now make an additional cut in between, and you've got roughly the size of a chicken fry. This made 8 chicken fries with just half a breast. In total, you can make 32 chicken fries for $6 worth of chicken.
You can have it. I'll eat that one. Eat it. But you like it, right?
Once your Cheetos are ground up, toss them into the batter pro along with some flour.
And the secret ingredient. Drum roll, please. Mac and cheese, the dry type, the weird type that you have to add milk to. That way it tastes okay. This kind happens to be thick and creamy, my favorite. You can use all of these noodles for another day. This is gonna take this to another level, JP.
Dangerously cheesy.
Thick and creamy cheesy.
Whatever happened to good old fashioned mac and cheese?
Yeah, they didn't have it at the store. Oh no!
While JP cleans up, thoroughly coat your chicken in flour, then toss it into our egg wash, and finally into our batter pro.
We love the batter pro.
We love it.
Link in the description.
It's so great. We love this thing. Link in the description.
They're so cheesy. Look how cheesy those are.
Oh my god, look how cheesy.
Look how cheesy. All right, now we fry.
Now we fry.
I said that.
No, me.
And it's that easy, guys. Cheeto chicken fries that you can try on the fly.
Like a tie-dye chicken thigh, fry, drive, fry, cry, lie.
Oh, God.
Quick, what's another word that rhymes?
All right, guys, so the Cheeto chicken fries, they're not out yet, but they can be.
In your kitchen.
And we also decided to do a flaming hot version. Comment below, what would you dip your Cheeto chicken fry into?
I think more cheese again would probably
more
be
cheese.
Best.
Yeah, we'll see blue cheese.
Blue cheese.
That's still cheese. Mm. Tastes more like real chicken. Burger King version is definitely that ground chicken.
Seems like a tube of chicken almost though.
Would you say they're about twice the size?
They're a little girthy.
These are really good though. try the Cheeto dusted one. So we dusted the other ones with Cheetos. I don't think it really looks that good because of the color difference between the fry version.
Oh my God.
But it's so good, right?
If the Cheeto flavor's there, like it is on these ones, you don't need to dip it.
The minute you fry a Cheeto, you're taking away a lot of the cheesy flavor. Bake your chicken fries.
So bread them, freeze them, and then stick them in the oven, 400 degrees, go home and make this. And when you're done, take a photo of it and send it over to us because we love seeing your pictures of your food and we put it all over our fan page that you can see here. JP's gonna put it right in front of you.
Yeah, and don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. It really does help us out. So I'm reminding you right now, thumbs this video up.
You guys worked together. You got over 10,000 likes on our last video posted. Popcorn chicken from KFC. Stay tuned for Galaxy Mac and Cheese.
We're gonna be doing Galaxy Mac and Cheese, and we're also going to be doing a little secret bonus hidden video before it. I didn't think we were gonna do Cheetos again. We did them again. But you know what? This time we keep perfecting the chicken fry.
It's Cheeto week on Healthy Junk Food.
Why is Cheeto week?
If you want to see more Cheeto recipes, make sure to check out these related videos here and here. We'll see you next time on another episode of Healthy Junk Food. You gonna throw something at me?
No.
I got you a bouquet.
Twizzlers?
Yes. You're welcome.
He really does love me. It smells like Twizzlers. Smell it. No, for real, smell it.
Don't keep doing that. First of all, that's actually really scary when you do that because I don't know when you're going to do it.
Give it a sniff and then tell me what it smells like.
It smells like Twizzlers.
That's what I was getting at. Woo! It's a mess over there. There's a lot of Twizzlers.